Why does email I send fail, but a reply to the same person works? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question: I have a relative with a Hotmail address. If I send her a message, it comes back undeliverable. Yet, if she sends me a message, I can click on reply and it goes through. What's up? Well, you're probably sending to the wrong email address. I know, you're absolutely convinced you're sending to the right one, but the bounce message would indicate otherwise. I've had it happen to me. I was absolutely convinced until I saw my errors. Let's look at why the two scenarios are different. When you send a new email to someone, the email address you send to comes from either of two places. You type the email address in by hand, or you use your address book or contacts list or some kind of autofill so that it gets entered automatically. Errors can come in with either method, and they can be very, very subtle. When you reply to a message, however, the email address you're sending to comes from the email message you're replying to and nowhere else. It can still be wrong, of course, but because it is the email address of the other person, they're the one that typed it in, and presumably they typed it in correctly. Now, before we get into the details of how things can go wrong, we do need to review what makes up an email address. There are two parts: the display name and the email address. They're often displayed together, like Ask Leo, and then in angle brackets, leo@askleo.com. The display name is, as its name implies, the text we see and recognize as someone's name. The email address follows it in angle brackets. The first source of confusion is that the display name itself can look like an email address. leo@askleo.com can be both the display name and the email address. There's nothing wrong with that, but it's important to realize that even though it looks like an email address, the display name is not the email address. Consider this one: leo@askleo.com as the display name, but leo@askleo.com, in other words, it's got an extra E in there, the typo is in my first name, as the email address. The display name looks correct, and it's possible that might be the only thing you see. But the email address, the address used to actually send your message, is wrong. So, like I said, in an effort to keep things simple, many email programs will only display the display name and hide the email address. You may be able to hover over a link or look for more information to see the actual email address that you're about to send something to. You won't know if the email address is wrong without looking deeper. Even worse is when the display name looks like an email address, but the actual email address is both different and incorrect. It looks right, but if you hover over it, you'll see the actual email address has that pesky typo, and it just won't work. So, what could go wrong? Well, email addresses must be exactly correct. It's really easy to mistype. A keyboard bounce, a slipped finger, and suddenly you're sending email to something wrong instead of the correct email address. Even more subtle might be typos. Now, I want to show you this one because I've actually set up a scenario where this is going to happen. We're here in Gmail, and I'm going to first compose a new message. I'm going to say, leo@askleo. And you can see that actually looks pretty cool. You can see it's currently showing me only my Ask Leo, the display name. If I click on it or hover over it, you'll see it says leo@askleo.com. Looks great. Let's see, we'll call this a test message. Say hello, and we'll send it. Now, that message is going to fail. And it's going to be so not obvious why it's going to fail. There it is. It just came in. My test message, I got a bounce on it. Address not found. Your message wasn't delivered to leo@askleo.com because the domain askleo.com wasn't found. What? And yet, if we take a very, very close look at that email address and the domain that it can't find, we zoom in on that, you'll see that, oh, wait a minute, that's not Ask Leo at all. That's Ask IEO. If we take a look at the entry that I created in my address book, this is actually ASK uppercase IEO. You would not know it was wrong just by looking at it. And yet, because it's in the address book, it's going to be one of the suggestions. And it's very common and very easy to just say, yep, the suggestion that's being made is who I want to send it to. You accept the suggestion, and you're sending to something wrong. Now, in order to manufacture this scenario, I used my address book. But in reality, many email programs and interfaces will accept whatever you type in as correct as soon as you hit send and add it to a list of future suggestions. Of course, if you add a typo to your address book, well, even worse. But the idea here is that there are a lot of ways that typos can get saved when you don't really want them to. Now, if I go back to my inbox and I go back to an email that was truly from leo@askleo.com, and I just hit reply to it, it kind of sort of looks the same, right? It says askleo.com, but this time we know that that is correct because it came from leo@askleo.com. I'm replying to it, and I'm relying not on my address book, not on any automated autofill, but I'm relying on the sender in this case actually having typed in their own email address correctly when they set up their account. All right, so with all of that information, what do we do? How do we fix things? Well, since your emails go through when you reply, look really carefully at the email address that's being used when you reply. Make sure you're looking at the email address and not the display name. Make a very careful note of it. Perhaps even copy-paste it somewhere like Notepad, where you can see it, and you can even make it easier to see by perhaps changing the font size to be something larger. Now, search in your address book to see if you have an entry for this recipient. Then, either carefully edit the email address to be correct, perhaps even pasting in the email address you just copied from a reply since you know that works. Do this even if it looks correct. If I were to do this with my example address book here, I'd be replacing something that looks like leo@askleo.com on top of something that looks like leo@askleo.com, except they're different. By pasting the email address you know to be correct, you're avoiding all of the assumptions. Or just delete the contact so that it's never suggested as a send-to email address again or until you add it back. When you add it again, don't type it in, but use your email program's add to address book function on the from address of a message that you received. That'll have the same effect as copying the pasting the email address correctly. Then compose a new message and start typing the email address you intend to send to. Pay extremely close attention to the suggestions made by your email program. Delete any that are incorrect. Exactly how to do that is going to depend on exactly what email program or interface you're using. After you've entered the email address and the email program has placed it into the To field, hover over it, click it, or take whatever steps are necessary to once again confirm that it's actually sending to the correct exact email address that you think it is. Now, one of the more frustrating aspects of dealing with email delivery problems is that saying that the email bounced is the equivalent to saying it didn't work. It gives me zero information. The contents of email bounce messages, such as that shown at the top of the article that this is based on, such as the one we just saw from Gmail, they've got a lot more information about why the email bounced. Read the entire bounce carefully. Look for clues and pass them on then to whomever you're reaching out to for help. While an incorrect email address is usually the culprit, other things can go wrong. The contents of that bounce message hold clues as to what to do next. So, whenever email bounces back to you, Take the time to carefully read the bounce message. It always has clues. If the problem is related to the email address you're sending to, such as the bounce message stating that it doesn't exist, then make sure you've got the exact correct email address you think you do. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/117124. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.